Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to learn numericals related to properties of materials. So let us start with first example. In example 1, an elastic rod is there having diameter of 30 mm, which is 10 cm long, and it extends by 2.5 cm under tensile load of 28 kN. We need to find the stress, strain and Young's modulus for the material of the rod. Okay, so let us start with the data which is given. Diameter D is equal to 30 mm, right? We are solving the numericals in MKS system, so don't forget to convert the units ever. Okay, then L is 10 cm, so again it will be 10 into 10 is to minus 2 meter. Then it extends by 2.5 cm. So the extension is denoted by small l, 2.5 into 10 is to minus 2 meter. And load, that is force, is 28 kN. So it will be 28 into 10 is to 3 Newton. Okay, first of all, we need to find stress. So stress is nothing but force upon area. So force F upon area pi r square. Now let us substitute the value of force. Force is 28 into 10 raised to 3. Area will be 3.14 into 15 square into 10 raised to minus 6. Now how this value came? D is given 30 mm. So we know that LR will be D by 2. So this is how this 15 into 10 to minus 6 came. Okay, so this will be 3.96 into 10 raised to 7 Newton per meter square. Okay, so this is how stress is calculated. Now strain. Very simple, strain is change in length upon original length. Change in length upon original length. So change in length is 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 2. Original length is 10 into 10 raised to minus 2. So it will be simply 0.25, is this cancel out. So it will be 0.25. Remember that strain is a dimensionless quantity. So no unit will be there. Okay. Okay. Lastly, we need to find Young's modulus. So Young's modulus is the ratio of stress to strain. So stress is 3.96 into 10 raised to 7. Strain is 0.25. So the value of Young's modulus will be 1.58 into 10 raised to 8 Newton per meter square. As strain has no unit, so the unit of Young's modulus and stress will be same. Now let us go through the another example, example 2. So example 2 says a piece of copper wire has twice the radius of a piece of steel wire. One end of the copper wire is joined to one end of the steel wire so that both can be subjected to the same longitudinal force. Remember this thing that it has been mentioned that it is they are having same longitudinal force. By what fraction of its length will the steel wire be stretched when the length of copper wire has increased by 1%? Young's modulus for steel is twice that for copper. Okay, so first of all, what is given? Piece of copper wire has twice the radius of piece of steel wire. So copper wire's radius is twice the radius of steel wire. Okay, let us suppose that RC is the radius of copper wire and RS is the radius of steel wire. Okay, then both are having same longitudinal force. Okay, then By what fraction length of steel wire be stretched when the length of copper wire has increased 1%? Okay, so it will be LC upon NC. L, small LC is the change and capital LC is the original. Young's modulus of steel wire is twice of that of copper wire. Okay, so as we can write that Young's modulus is stress upon strain, right? So this can be written as force upon area, change in length upon L. So using this equation, we'll write FC as YC AC LC whole divided by capital LC. Okay, similarly YA S AS LS upon whole divided by LS. Okay, so now we'll write YC as it is. AC will be pi R C square and LC. Okay, also LC by LC is given 0.1. Okay, so YS pi RS square LS by LS, right? Okay, now let us write it as YC pi RC. Okay, so we know that RC is nothing but 2RS. So here instead of RC we'll write 4RS square. Okay, instead of RC square. Also this LC by LC is 0.01. So let us substitute the value of 0.01. Okay, so this will be equal to YS. YS is 2YC. So here it will be 2YC pi RS square. Okay, LS by LS. Now we need to find this, how much the steel wire is stretched. So this LS by, in order to find LS by LS, right, let us write here LS by LS. Let us take this quantity in the denominator, 4RS square into 0.01 whole divided by 2YC pi RS square. So this cancel out, pi cancel out, yc cancel out. So we'll get 2 into 0.01. So ls by ls is equal to 0.02. Okay, so in this way, right, the steel wire will be stretched by 2% when the length of copper wire is increased by 1% or 0.01. okay, so now let us go through another example which states that a copper wire of 3 meter length, 0.001 diameter, having a Young's modulus of 12.5 into 10 raised to 10 newton per meter square. What is the extension produced if a weight of 10 kg is attached to one free end? What lateral compression is produced if the Poisson's ratio is 0.26? Okay, so let us solve this equation. We just saw that Y can be written as force upon area, length upon L. So in this way, this extension will be FL upon A into Y. Okay, so force is not given but mass is given, so we can take F as mg. Okay, so 10 into 9.8 will be there. Length is given 3 meter, diameter is given. So we can write pi r square as 0.001 by 2 square as d, r is equal to d by 2. Then Young's modulus is 12.5 into 10 raised to 10. So in this way we will get length as 2.9 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. Okay. Now we know that Poisson's ratio is the ratio of lateral strain to longitudinal strain. Okay, and we know we need to find the lateral compression only. So R by R will be Poisson's ratio into L by L. Okay, So R by R can be written as 0.26 into 2.9 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by 3. So this lateral compression will come out 2.59 into 10 raised to minus 4. Okay, or we can also write D by D, right? Or R by R, the value will be same, 2.59 into 10 raised to minus 4. So this is how you calculate the lateral compression. Okay, now next example. Calculate the work done in stretching a wire through 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter of a certain material whose cross section is 1 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter square and length is 2 meter. Young's modulus is also given. The formula of work is y a l square by 2l. Okay, so let us substitute the value. Young's modulus is 2 into 10 raised to 11. What will be the area? Area is 1 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter square mentioned in the question. Okay, small l is the stretch, right, which is given 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 3, and original length is 2 meter. Okay, so in this way we'll get work as 5 into 10 raised to minus 4. What is the unit of work? It is joule. Right, so this is a simple numerical. Now next numerical. Okay, so in this example we need to find the force required to increase the length of a steel wire of this much area of cross section by 50% whose Young's modulus is this much. Okay, so what is given? Area is given 10 raised to minus 6 meter square. This is also very simple numerical. Young's modulus is 2 into 10 raised to 11 newton per meter square. Also, we need to find the force required to increase the length by 50%, which means that the extension is 50% of that of original length, right? Okay, so we know that Y is equal to F upon A L by L. So F will be Y A L upon L. Okay, so Y is 2 into 10 raised to 11, area is 10 raised to minus 6, stretch is L by 2, the length in extension is L by 2 and original length is L. So in this way L cancel out, 2 cancel out, so F will be 10 raised to 5 newton. Okay, so this is how you calculate the value of force, right? So that's all for this session. These are all the numericals related to the force, work done, Poisson's ratio, Young's modulus of elasticity. Okay, so this is all about this session. Thank you.